Kondisi perang yang terasa tanpa ujung tentu membuat kehidupan di kota Kabul dan seluruh Afghanistan tidak bisa berjalan dengan normal. Korban pertama adalah anak-anak. Mereka kehilangan tempat bermain, tempat belajar, dan bahkan tempat beribadah.
Anak-anak di Afghanistan. Hello everyone.
Hi.
Hi.
How are you?
Say hi from Kabul, Afghanistan.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Hi. Hi from Indonesia.
Indonesia.
Yeah.
Hi.
Can you say hello Indonesia?
Hello Indonesia.
Yeah.
Hari ini saya berada di bagian timur kota Kabul untuk melihat fasilitas masjid dan klinik, tempat anak-anak dan dewasa bisa bermain, beribadah, dan berobat. Masjid dan klinik Indonesia ini dibangun di daerah Ahmad Syababamena, yang mayoritas dihuni oleh warga suku Pashtu, salah satu permukiman terpadat di seluruh Afghanistan. Meski Afghanistan adalah negara Islam, tidak berarti jumlah masjid selalu memadai jumlah warga, apalagi fasilitas kesehatan seperti rumah sakit dan klinik. Itu sebabnya lokasi ini dipilih sebagai lokasi pembangunan masjid dan klinik Indonesia.
Klinik yang dibuat oleh Republik Indonesia ada di belakang saya. Jadi ini klinik persahabatan antara Indonesia dan Afghanistan. Tidak berapa jauh lah itu. Masih dalam satu kompleks area masjid yang juga dibuat oleh Indonesia dan dipersembahkan untuk warga Afghanistan. Dan ini tentu saja bekerja sama juga dengan pihak di Afghanistan sendiri. Pak Nasir, salah satu yang terlibat dalamnya. Mr. Nasir, very nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, brother.
So fine. You are part of the initiation of the mosque building and also the building of this clinic. Yeah. Could you tell us how hard was it to convince the Afghan the government and also the people around here?
Yeah, in the beginning a little bit it was very difficult for us to convince the people that we are going to make a building or clinic here. But when they heard that we are building a big component over here, we start, you know, the first in the beginning, the mosque here. When the mosque was built, so the people became very happy. In a very high quality, we made, you know, the mosque. And because there is a lot of population in over here in the Ahmad Syababamena.
Okay.
So they need these things. So when we built the mosque, the people are very happy, and they said that, oh, that's a good thing that you build it for us. And they are very thankful from the Indonesian people that they built a mosque for us.
Did they know about Indonesia before?
No, before that they don't know about Indonesian peoples and Indonesian culture, Indonesian. Then they know after when we built the mosque, the Indonesian people come inside to the mosque and they pray with
together.
The people together. So then they said, oh, Indonesian peoples are Muslims and they are praying with us and they made us mosque for us. And when the mosque built, the people said that, wow, that's a very good thing that they built us for us. And after that, we have the next project from Indonesian. Yeah, the clinic,
okay.
Which is in third floor, we already made it. And the people are now coming and they are, you know, the patients are using from the clinic.
Okay.
And the people are very happy, very, very happy, because after the mosque, we start the clinic. A lot of people, they are coming and they are asking, what are you going to build it here?
Yeah.
So then we told them that, okay, we are building here the clinic. So the people become very happy because the government clinics are very far away from this.
How far?
It's around...
like if you ride a car?
Around, yeah, you must take the car. It's around 4 or 5 kilometers far from here.
I see.
Yeah, so and the population is very, you know, too much here.
Very dense.
Very dense.
This is, what I heard is this is the most dense area.
Dense area. Because of that, in one clinic, which is very far from here, it's not enough for the patients.
Okay.
Because they just have maybe 4 or 5 beds.
Oh, I see.
So you know, Indonesian clinic are very, you know, well equipped, and they have a lot of beds
for,
and also
how many
OPD,
beds?
32
okay.
Beds.
You are from an NGO actually, not from the government.
Yeah,
you are an
yeah,
NGO.
Yeah, I'm from NGO.
Who works with the Indonesian embassy to
yeah,
create this.
To so, create this, yeah.
How many of these, the mosques and also friendship clinics, that is needed around Kabul or even Afghanistan? How is the situation actually, as you see?
You know, government hospitals are very less in Afghanistan, especially in Kabul. And also provinces, in the many other provinces, we don't have, you know, clinics, government clinics. For example, in the east side, the Jalalabad, you know, or Nangarhar province, we just have one or two clinics, which is belong to the government. And also in other Logar province, for example, in Logar province, we have just two clinics.
Two clinics which is for how many people?
For too much population, because this is a, you know, a province.
For a province, only two clinics?
Yeah, only two clinics province. In whole province we have.
Dan sumbangan ini pun disambut sangat baik oleh warga Afghanistan di lokasi. Namun tentu masih banyak lagi kebutuhan mendasar yang dibutuhkan oleh warga yang serba berkekurangan.
The mosque that we have here now, how are the people around here? And you live also around the mosque. How are they accepting this?
Well, the people are really happy. As I mentioned before, we need education. We need mosques, we need buildings, we need hospitals, clinics. Indonesia, as people were not very aware of Indonesian country, but now they're aware, they're most aware of Indonesia country. They're really happy.
What do they think welcome. About Indonesia?
Indonesia is an Islamic country. We're all Muslims. The Muslims are all one body, actually. We're all one body. All Muslims. We love Indonesia because they are helping us.
Kehadiran Indonesia tidak hanya berupa manusia dan bangunan saja. Indonesia berkomitmen terlibat langsung dalam diplomasi damai di Afghanistan dan hasilnya sudah mulai terlihat nyata. Saya akan ajak Anda melihat kelanjutan ceritanya dalam bagian kedua Sapa Diplomat dari Kabul, Afghanistan pekan depan.